In this video, I'm going to show you why I ditched ChatGPT Plus and Claude Pro subscriptions and how you can too, and save some money while freeing your AI in the meantime. Okay, here's the pain. Sometimes I'm on holiday, chilling out, and I'm still paying multiple $20 subscriptions a month for ChatGPT, for Claude, for Google Gemini. And other times I'm working away, coding like a rabbit and doing other things with AI, and I hit the dreaded rate limit. These monthly subscriptions to different AI, such as ChatGPT, Claude, and Gemini Pro, have been absolutely brilliant for me and so convenient, but I couldn't help but think there might be a better solution. Maybe I self-host, so I'm not sending my data up to big companies, and I've got something that's more private, particularly in the business world where I want to look after the data I have. Also, what if I could mix chats? Say I could start off chatting to ChatGPT and then get Claude to check the work for me. Then there's things like unlimited GPTs. Yeah, you can do that too. This also works with vision, so you can upload anything you want and get any AI that supports it to visually analyze your data. Plus, you could host a completely local model, meaning you need no internet. You can disconnect all Ethernet wires and Wi-Fi signals and chat to an AI in your house or on your business premises without any connection to the internet. Plus, I found something with multiple login ability. This is great for Teams. Before ChatGPT had a Teams account, I was sharing one account with multiple people, obviously not a great practice, and you've got better availability. So just imagine this, OpenAI has an outage, you can't ask ChatGPT anything, you can just switch the model, it's as easy as that, in a drop-down tab, and you can start chatting to another AI. Okay, so I'm sold, this all sounds very good. What is this superpower AI app that can do everything and allow you to talk to any AI that exists? Well, I'm going to show you how to install something that can work for free on your local computer, or you can run it very cheaply on a server in the cloud. But if you don't want to get technical, simply go to the link down below and visit TypingMind. You can thank me later. When you hit TypingMind, you'll see that you can start for free by entering your API key here to different services. I can generate a new key to use ChatGPT for TypingMind right here. Copy and paste. The same with Claude. I can create a new key, save these keys, and I could also do the same with Google Gemini if I wish. Now it's really easy because I just type in as I usually would to ChatGPT. I'm not sure I totally appreciate that joke, so let's cross-check it by switching to Claude. Okay, maybe arguably Claude gave me a better joke there. So you can see in the same conversation thread, I started talking to ChatGPT and then I switched to Claude. And that's the beauty of this kind of solution. So TypingMind will do a great job. There is a link to it down below in the description. You can click the buy button and you pay a one-off fee to get a lifetime license, which is a pretty good deal. So if you were looking for something to free up your AI and pay as you go, there's the solution. You can stop the video now. Quick one. Did you know most people that make it to this point in the video are not yet subscribed? And it's proven in a recent survey that those that are subscribed to my channel are more intelligent. Remember to like and subscribe to this video. Thanks. But I know that most of you are here to learn how to do this kind of thing yourself and even host it on your own computer at home or a server that you spin up in the cloud. So let's do that next, and I'm going to be using LibreChat. Now, LibreChat is a completely open source project. It allows you to mix different AIs inside one brilliant interface that actually looks rather like ChatGPT. It also has tons of other superpowers that I'm going to show you as we go along with this video. Now, I'm going to be using Linode to host this on a server in the cloud. It's very cheap to do that, and actually you get $100 of free credit if you use my Linode link below. Now, this is your own private server. It charges by the hour, so if you mess around with it for just an hour, it's going to cost you a fraction of a cent to host that server. Otherwise, the server I'm going to pick is in a region close to me, so I'm going to pick Sweden here, and then I'm going to go for a shared CPU and the Nanode 1 GB, which is $5 monthly. Okay, now we're in business. So all I need to do is copy the SSH access and put it into my Mac's terminal. Now, you could do the same inside Windows command line or even Linux if you're using that. Enter the password and I'm in. Now, I'm just going to run a few maintenance commands. Firstly, I'm going to run apt update. Then I'll run apt upgrade. And then I'll pop open the install instructions for LibreChat here, which I'll also link down below so you can do it for yourself and follow along. The quick start is here, and they suggest that you have Git and Docker installed, so that's really easy. One line command to do it, apt install git docker.io docker-compose. So now it's just a case of following everything that's listed in the install instructions. It's really easy. Let me show you. First, I'm going to copy the Git clone repo. Next command, I'll navigate to the LibreChat folder. Then it's telling us to create a .env file. This is essentially where we'll configure LibreChat and place our API keys. Again, copy and paste. And just before I get hot and heavy and ready to spin this up and start LibreChat, I'm going to edit that .env file. So a great command line text editor is Nano. Now, don't get overwhelmed by everything that's in here. You can tweak this to your heart's content in the future, but we're just going to do two things. First, using Control V to scroll down, and we'll enter our Anthropic API key, which I've generated here in my Claude API console. Again, I'll link this down below. There we go. And then Control V to just scroll down a little bit more in this text file. And then we'll find the OpenAI API key right here. And again, making sure I've created an OpenAI API key. Again, link for this down below. Create the secret key and paste it into my .env file. Then I'll do Control X and Y and enter, and that will write the changes to the file. That was really easy. That's all I have to do. Next, the final command is docker compose up-d. That will start LibreChat. Okay, that really is it. Took me about a minute, and that's now running on my server in the cloud. Let's test it out. So here you can see to access LibreChat, it suggests going to localhost colon 3080. Don't do that. That would be if you're running it on a computer inside your home. But as we're hosting this in the cloud, we need to go back to Linode for a moment and grab the public IP address right here. Copy it. Then I'll open a new browser window, enter that IP address, and then hit colon 3080. And boom, now we have a login screen that looks kind of similar to ChatGPT. And let me remind you, this is your own AI interface that you own and host on your own server in the cloud. How cool is that? Okay, so let's get started by signing up. And then enter those credentials that we just used to sign up. Wow, okay, this is crazy. This is looking exactly like ChatGPT, although we have some extra features here that we'll get into in just a moment. So let me just close this sidebar. We'll leave this open. Now, one of the coolest things about this is you can search messages up here, which you don't get with ChatGPT. A fantastic feature because I'm always generating things that I want to get back to in the future. Search is an incredible feature. Let's try it out. Best workout to do on my bike in 30 minutes. And you'll notice up here, I'm using ChatGPT 4 preview. It's got every model here, so I can use whatever I like. I might switch to GPT 4 Turbo and let's ask. Okay, that's pretty impressive as an answer I'd expect to get from ChatGPT. And here I'm paying as I go, only for what I use for. So obviously I'm going to run this for a few months and let you know how the costs work out. But I think in the long term, I'll probably make a saving and have better access and uptime to my favorite AI models. You'll see there's the ability to edit here. If I want to edit anything in the text, I can also go ahead and copy just like I can in the ChatGPT interface. I can refresh to ask for another response, and I can even fork my conversation, an advanced feature of LibreChat, allowing me to choose to fork off to a different branch so I can use different models and really experiment with the AI language model that I'm using. Next up, we're going to tweak with some settings down here. So again, down in the bottom left, we've got settings here, very much like OpenAI's ChatGPT interface. I've got the general settings, so a dark theme, don't know why you'd want to have it light. Auto scroll to the newest on open, that's your newest chat. You can hide the right panel by default. You can also sort out your archive chats. You've got messages here, so enter to send messages is always good, and a bunch of other options. Some beta features as well. Now, I like to have this one on, enable switching endpoints mid-conversation. Watch this. Write simple code to animate the words "Hello, Mum" on screen. Okay, and as you can see here, GPT-4 has given me a simple HTML file to use, so I can copy that code. Then I'll use one of my favorite text editors to save this, and then we'll go ahead and open it up, see what it looks like. Yeah, you know, that's kind of okay, right? It is doing exactly what I asked, using a bit of CSS, JavaScript, and HTML. I quite like it. But is this the very best solution? This is what GPT-4 Turbo has given us, but wouldn't it be great to easily cross-check that code with something like Claude 3 Opus, a powerful model from Anthropic? It's as easy as clicking up here, selecting from OpenAI across to Anthropic, and you'll see there's a bunch of other models you can add in. Claude 3 Opus is the default, but if I didn't want to pay so much, I can switch to Haiku, which is a much cheaper model from Anthropic. But let's stick with Opus. I've asked, is this the very best code for purpose? Please improve it and make it even better. And the best thing is, just like a normal AI chat, it'll remember everything I've said earlier. Wow, okay, so it's finished. Now you'll see my chat started with GPT-4 and then ended with Claude. That's incredible, isn't it? And I've got a new HTML file here, which I'm going to copy the code to. Next, I'll open my new and improved Claude 3 Opus model. Whoa! Okay, I'm not sure what Claude has done there, but it's going crazy. Oh yeah, there it is. If I hover, it does indeed pause it, but that is giving me a real eyesore. Maybe ChatGPT won that challenge. One last try, and again, I'm going to switch back to OpenAI, and this time I'm going to go really cheap. I'm going to cheap out with GPT 3.5 Turbo. Here I've said the latest code you gave me was rubbish, the text animates too fast, please slow text down and make many colors like a rainbow. I also dislike white backgrounds, so make it darker. Okay, and that was really quick. So remember, I started with some powerful models that cost a little bit more to run because I'm paying for every request now, albeit just fractions of a cent. But now GPT 3.5 Turbo has taken the earlier code, which I can copy, and one more time. Well, that's nice. It is a rainbow hello mum, but yeah, that text definitely is not animating. I'm just making it bigger so you can see it nice and clearly. Yeah, the rainbow colors are good, but the rest GPT 3.5 Turbo ignored. So I did mention there are some really powerful vision capabilities within LibreChat too. So if I go ahead and switch to Anthropic and start a new chat with Claude 3 Opus, I can actually use the attachment symbol, just like in ChatGPT, to attach an image. I'm going to attach this thumbnail here, and I've asked Claude 3 Opus to tell me what you see. And I'm sure you'll agree that that's a pretty good description that Claude 3 Opus has given me. So vision is indeed possible inside LibreChat. And what's more, everything I upload is hosted on my server, either in the cloud or locally. And if I hit this little attach files thing here, you'll see I can always recall stuff I've uploaded if I need to use it multiple times. Now, how about that search feature? Something we don't presently have in ChatGPT. I can search my messages over here. And remember earlier I asked about a bike workout? Bike, and you'll see, yes, it finds just that chat that I had earlier, the best bike workout. And you can imagine when I have hundreds or thousands of conversation threads, I can quickly click back in and get that conversation back on the screen. The final feature I want to show you inside this really cool LibreChat open source application is the ability to have presets. So they're kind of like unlimited GPTs, and they're not just restricted to OpenAI and ChatGPT. You can use them with Claude or any other model you have running here. So let's start a new chat, and let's actually start it with Anthropic's Claude 3 Opus. And here I'm going to go up into the presets area here. You'll see I can choose a model. I can set a custom name, so YouTuber. Custom instructions I'll keep really simple. I've said you are a YouTuber with a channel like this and pasted in the description for my Creator Magic YouTube channel. I've got other things I can alter, like the temperature, so how prompt adherent it is, and other bits, also max output tokens as well. So that can all then be saved as my own set of custom instructions. And I'll call the preset YouTuber. And now I can always recall that by just going up here into this icon and selecting my YouTuber preset. Okay, YouTuber is active. Message YouTuber down here. So I'm going to ask it for some ideas. Give me 5 new video ideas for my channel. And there you go. It's given me 5 solid ideas for my channel because it knows all about me from the presets, top 5 AI-powered video editing tools, automating your podcast workflow with AI, AI-generated music, revolutionizing thumbnail design and creator spotlight, just the kind of stuff that I would actually feature on this channel. So there you go. Everything I've spoken about in this video will be linked up down below, so click those links to try everything out. I really hope you enjoy playing either non-technically with TypingMind or getting your feet in the weeds and really going to town, creating an amazing free open source AI solution with LibreChat. I think it's the best. There's loads of solutions out there that do this kind of thing, but out of my experience, LibreChat has proven to be the best, and I've been using this for a while. I am really liking it, and I've scratched the surface. You can really spend ages setting up every different AI model there and combining your chats. Even in the future, I'd like to do a tutorial where you can have a completely locally hosted AI that doesn't even connect to the internet and works right inside LibreChat. Pretty fascinating, right? Now, finally, if you've enjoyed this tutorial and you're hungry for more, you should go and watch this video next. It's where I show you a similar way to install an AI workflow automation tool that can automate almost everything in your life. It's going to be amazing, and it's going to make life so much easier for you. Go and watch it now. Well, go on then.